Thank you very much. I am from Sri Lanka. I think having heard all the articulations made by eminent lecturers, I thought that Sri Lanka has a little better story to tell you. Because the statistic that I have brought in, we have a population of 20.6 million. Every year we get about 3.7 lakhs of live births. And under 5 children, you get about 460,000. And number of adolescents is about 40 million. 40,000. Number of pregnant mothers is about 3.8 lakhs. And maternal mortality ratio is about 33.5% per 100,000 live births. Under 5 mortality rate is 12 per 1,000. Infant mortality rate is 10.2 per 1,000. Immunization coverage is 98%. This is all because I believe the literacy rate that we have in our country is about 98-99%. And in addition to that, we have 3 major officers in each village to look after these activities. That is, number one is Grama Sevaka. He looks after the administration and other basic complaints and things like that. And there's a family health worker in every village. So that lady goes right around the village and looks after the pregnant mothers and other family matters, health, nutrition, and all that. And she is a public officer paid by the government. And there's another officer called Agricultural Extension Officer. Now he's there to help the farmers and to look after that aspect of their lives. So, the cooperative society is well in active, and the small for microfinance, things like that. And especially we have focused, as everyone emphasized, the women of the family. So they are much more secured, especially the microfinance and repaying of their loans is 99% now. Earlier it was 30-40%, now it has been increased to 99%. And they have a rural bank. That bank is the third richest bank in the country. So so like that, it has been improving very fast. But I can see the low birth weight rate has been coming down since 1988. It's very significantly. And but unfortunately, in the estate sector, we have in the middle of the country, we have a large tea plantation, rubber plantation, and in that sector, the literacy rate is very poor. And on the other hand, and they have no time to listen to anybody. They go early in the morning to work and come back late in the evening. So hardly any time for them to talk to somebody or be with them. And Sundays they leave and they make use of other activities of their family. So that's the problem. But now the government has introduced the same system that had been in the other part of the country to look after their health. But still the live birth rate is still high, still low. Malnutrition among under 5 children also, it has also have been coming down since 1975 to 2006. The figures are is coming down very significantly. And the problem that we have encountered at the moment is the anemia. So that has also had come down, but still in it's in alarming rate as we think. So that earlier it was for pregnant women, it had been in 1988 it was about 30.3, now it has come down to 16.7. So like that it has come down everything, but still we believe it's an high sign. And the percentage of people getting less than the recommended level of calories, still in high side, is more than 50% now, 50.7%. So this low birth weight rate is static, so we have to attend to that. And protein energy is also, it has not been shown a significant change. Iron deficiency is in a high side. Vitamin A deficiency is in high side. Major problems among pregnant and lactating mothers is protein energy, malnutrition and anemia. So these are the things that we have to attain. And the problem that has emerged is at the moment in urban areas, the obesity and then the hypertension, heart diseases, diabetes and carcinomas. So these are problems that we have seen at the moment. For this purpose, the government has adopted a nutritional policy, and this is under implementation now. And a special presidential task force has been appointed, and that is in operation at the moment. It's a very speedy work has been done, and the agricultural sector has been asked to go in for growing more nutritious grains like green gram, black gram, and finger millets, maize, and things like that. And also rice varieties, we have the local varieties which have been proven value with some proven value of medicinal values, they say diabetics and things like that. So that is on the way. But unfortunately, this climatic change has created a havoc in the country. Last 3 weeks it has been continuous raining and floods, and all what we have done on that is all washed away. 40% of the expected production, the yield, is totally perished. So if that is something that, now last time we had a severe drought, and this time we had severe floods. And if this trend is going to continue, there are going to be a bit of a problem. Whatever that we do, at the end, if the natural disasters can ruin us, so last time the tsunami ruined us, and then the drought came up, then the floods. So these are the things that we'll have to address our mind and how to encounter this type of problems in the future. If it is going on like this, definitely people will not bother about the nutrition of what you eat. They will have to get their stomachs filled with something. So that is the danger that we can think about. But still, now the government with the special task force has started a rural household development program. With that, we have distributed 10 chicken, 1 cow, and home garden plot assistance with a little money and some seeds, and now they are going ahead right around the country. That is for the purpose, because that is one of the measures that we have thought of, that we could meet this environmental challenge. Now, the main agricultural areas were perished, but now if you some part of the country is not affected, So what we thought was, now we'll go right round the country, this household development work, then if one side perishes, at least you will get the other side of it. So like that, to balance it in some way, now that regional task force is going, I hope that it would work well in the near future. Thank you very much.